Hey guys, good evening. This is Mukesh Morwal, your holistic wellness coach, and today we will be talking about vitamin D. Okay, what are vitamins? Vitamins are vital components required by your body, and you do not get it directly. It could be a water-soluble vitamin or a fat-soluble vitamin. You can compensate it either with your diet or maybe some other source. We will be talking about vitamin D today. It is also a precursor to hormonal balances, which means it is not just a vitamin. It is also a precursor to creating a lot of hormones. It is, by the way, also a fat-soluble vitamin, which means that you can easily compensate it, or you can mix it or integrate it with too many fats, healthy fats that we're talking about over here. If you have a deficiency of vitamin D, you will see a lot of symptoms related to it. One of them is allergies on your body. The second one is hair loss. Third one is insomnia or any kind of changes in your sleep levels. The fourth one is your gut issues. So many people, they come to us and they say that they have IBS or they have disturbed gut levels, and you know, they are, whenever they get anxious, they lose two things. One of them is their sleep. The second one is, you know, they start going and visiting the toilet more often, and they might have to visit the toilet as soon as they eat. One of the things that is very clear when they do their blood test is a few other components along with vitamin D deficiency. Normally, you know, because it's monsoons nowadays, so if you're in some place which has got adequate sunlight, you might get the right amount of vitamin D by taking direct sunlight on your body for at least 10 to 30 minutes, anywhere between 6 a.m. to 3 p.m. Yes, I might be a little bit different when I say that, you know, you can get quality sunlight even before 3 p.m. So even if you get 10 minutes of your time, 10 minutes to 30 minutes of direct sunlight on your body, that should be adequate. Too many people, they have harsh sunlight in the place that they live in, so they can take anywhere between 10 to 15 minutes of sunlight. It is also said that when you start applying any kind of sunscreen on your body, it actually inhibits the absorption of vitamin D. So please remember that you do not apply any kind of sunscreens on your face or on your body, because it needs to be direct. You should not be behind a glass, or you should not be behind a window while taking sunlight. It has to be directly falling on your skin so that you can, your skin can absorb it, and then it can make vitamin D. Vitamin D, yes, this is one of the vitamins that can be made by your body. Other vitamins cannot be made by your body, and that is why you need to intake it, or you need to take it from diets and supplements. Vitamin D, your body can make it with the help of sunlight. So what I'm trying to tell you over here is that the best way of getting the right amount of vitamin D is through sunlight. If you're not getting it, there are different types of supplements. One of the best supplements that I personally know, and I refer people to take it, is the powders that you get for around 30 to 50 rupees from most of the chemist shops. It could be called Sipcal, and it is available in powder form. You take it once or twice a week depending on your deficiency. If you're severely deficient, you need to be taking it twice a week just with water any time of the day. And you take it with a fasting of at least 1 to 2 hours. So do not eat anything before and after you take this powder. You can take it with half to one cup of water once or twice a week depending on your deficiency, so that you can maintain healthy levels. Now, based on your blood reports, you could be seeing different levels, which means, you know, you could be falling deficient into a different range, and then you could be sufficient in a different range. But this is exactly what you need to remember. If you are taking a vitamin D from sunlight for at least a week or so, your body can actually recover or compensate itself with at least 10,000 IU, which is international unit. And 10,000 IU is what you need to do, you know, what you might need to have for almost 2 to 3 months, or maybe 6 months, depending on your deficiency or depending on your insufficiency. And this is what we have tried. So month on month, you know, when I have seen that, you know, when I tell people to go out in sunlight and then they come back and give me the data from the group, we try to track it down. And after 6 or 4 months, we can once again do the blood test. And from that, this is the data that I have collected from my clients, my relatives, people who, you know, from whom I have gathered the data from. It could be different with you. One of the other things that you can easily get it from is mushrooms. So, you know, since I'm a plant-based person, I would not, you know, suggest you to take any kind of milk. When I say milk, it is cow milk that we're talking about. Anything else is perfectly fine, which is plant-based. And when I say plant-based, it actually takes off all of the meat of you know, whatever you could be thinking. So I rely only on sunlight or specific type of supplements. It could be plant-based supplements. Also, I also take a lot of sprouts and mushrooms to compensate my vitamin D levels. Now, if you're taking mushrooms every single day, either in boiled form or any other form, you need to remember that you don't burn the mushrooms so that you get actual the good quality of nutrition. You can have it boiled, you can have it steamed, or you can just mix it with salads by washing it properly. Take it just the way that you feel it is comfortable. Toxicity rarely happens. I do not know many people who have had that toxicity. Now, I know two or three people who were taking more than 40,000 IU in a day. And there are people who also take the powder, which is 60,000 IU, every single day for a month or so. I have not seen too many people having toxicity depending on their levels of vitamin D. However, the toxicity of vitamin D also indicates that you could be having issues with nervous system, you could be having drowsiness, you could be having fatigue, and there would be changes with your movement, overall movement. Deficiency, yes, certainly the deficiency includes hair fall, changes with your sleep levels. Too many people, when they suffer of insomnia or infertility or impotency, too many women also do not know that when they are suffering of PCOD, PCOS, infertility, it could be related to vitamin D. When you have lack of vitamin D, you could also be suffering of depression, and that's known. There are so many doctors who've already spoken about the connection of vitamin D with neurological issues. So please remember that you start taking your vitamin D adequately. And as I said, you can easily get it just by going into the sunlight anytime between 6 a.m. to 3 p.m. Questions that come up is that if you start going out in sunlight every single day, can it start darkening your complexion? Which means, can you get darker? I do not have to worry about it. Neither does anyone else have to worry about it. I remember, and I know too many people who swim in direct sunlight, who go out and run in sunlight. One of them is Milind Soman. You can Google his name. He is a known celebrity in India. He's also a runner. And you must have seen that he's got tanned skin, but he's not dark, right? Now, depending on your skin type, depending on your health, it changes your skin complexion. But remember that nothing is above health. So if you need sturdier bones, you need good immunity, you do not want acne, you do not want pimples, you do not want hair fall, you do not want to be obese, you do not want PCOD, PCOS, impotency, this is one thing that you can easily get without spending a single rupee. Just go out in the sunlight, take sunlight, and you should be perfectly fine. Remember vitamin D, just in case you're not able to get it, only then go for supplements. Right? Thanks a lot. Just in case you enjoyed my video, remember that you need to hit the like button so that I understand that you people like the way that I produce my content, put it up before you. If you have questions, you're always more than welcome to ask me. I see to it that I answer all of the comments. I look at every single comment which comes up either on the social media or on my website or on Instagram. You can also send me a direct message on Instagram. My Instagram ID is Mukesh Morwal. So you can find me on Instagram and you can send me a question, any question related to health, any point of time. Right? Rest everything, yes, if you find it interesting and if you feel that someone else can benefit from this information, please go ahead and hit the share button. Right? This is Mukesh Morwal saying, Namaste, stay smiling, stay healthy, stay glowing, and stay safe. Take care, bye-bye.